Good evening. Welcome to Chennai. I am Teresa. I am part of the World Vision India communication team. I am passionate about cooking and I keep trying out new recipes. Today I am going to teach you how to make vegetable pulao. Hi, now from the vegetable market, we are here at an open kitchen with lots of greenery around. I'm really honored to share this recipe with you. With me, I have Kevin. Hi, Kevin.
Hi, I'm Kevin from class 9, here to help my mother in cooking the vegetable pulao, and I'm glad to be part of this show.
Thanks, Kevin. In normal circumstances, we would be having this cooking demonstration at our communities. But because of the pandemic, we are here in this kitchen. So before I start cooking, let me explain to you all the ingredients that go into making the pulao. We have here half a cup of green peas. We have one potato, which we will chop into pieces. Tomatoes, we'll be using two tomatoes, medium-sized tomatoes. We have three onions. We have half a cup of chopped mint, half a cup of coriander leaves, beans. Then we have three ingredients in a cup. We have a carrot, we have green chilies, we have a lemon, tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. We have some coconut powder, which we will make it into a milk. We have oil, about 2 tablespoons of yogurt. This is ghee, which is optional. We have a set of condiments. We have a bay leaf, we have cloves, we have cinnamon, we have cashew nuts, which we will use for garnishing. Then we have rice, the last ingredient, which is the salt. And we would need a cooker or an open pot with a lid. Kevin, will you explain what these ingredients contain?
Yeah. Green peas contains vitamin B and fiber. Carrots contain vitamin A, and lemon contains vitamin C. Potatoes contain carbohydrates. Tomatoes contain vitamin C. Beans contains vitamin B and fiber. And ghee and oil both contain fats, including cashews. They also contain fats.
Thanks, Kevin. Okay, so now that we have all our ingredients in place, we'll start by chopping the vegetables. Malnutrition has lifelong damages on the health of the child. At World Vision, we have number of activities and intervention projects wherein we help to address, tackle malnutrition. We have a program called CMAM, which is Management of Acute Malnutrition. So we have this food baskets wherein we give pulses, cereals for about 6 months. We also encourage the parents to cook this one pot meal because it has all the essential ingredients for a very nutritious diet. And children actually will be able to get all the required vitamins if they have this meal. And this is precisely why we are having this cooking demonstration wherein we are teaching this recipe. We have other recipes which are similar, and we have these kind of cooking demonstration in our communities. Okay, now that the vegetables are chopped and all our ingredients are ready, let's start the cooking process. So we will need about 4 to 5 tablespoons of oil. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take about 3 tablespoons of sunflower oil, and I will add 1 tablespoon of ghee. Now the ghee is optional. You could add 4 tablespoons of oil, or you could add 3 tablespoons of oil and 1 tablespoon of ghee. So once this gets heated up, first to go into this would be our cashew nuts. So what we will do is we will slightly fry the cashew nuts till about a light golden brown and keep it aside. So we'll go with 2 small pieces of cinnamon, 2 cardamoms, 2 cloves. So once that starts bursting, you will first add the onions. So we've chopped about 3 onions. We will keep a bit of onions for the raita. We will fry them till they are little pinkish in color or golden in color. But mind you need to be very careful that they don't get burnt. Okay, now the onions have turned pink, as you can see here. So now what we will do is, we will add the mint leaves. So now your mint leaves have fried. What we are going to do is, we are going to add now 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. Now the ginger garlic paste has to fry a bit, but if you over fry, they start sticking to the pan bottom. Okay, so this 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste will have 1 teaspoon of garlic and 1 teaspoon of ginger. So if you add a little more, it will become more pungent. So you will have to take care of the quantity. Now the ginger garlic paste is almost done, it's fried. So now the next goes are tomatoes. So now we've added the tomatoes and we'll have to wait till they become mushy. Now once the tomatoes are little mushy, what you could add is, you could add the green chilies at this stage. And also you need to add your salt, because the salt will actually hasten the cooking of the tomatoes. So we will add 1.5 cup of vegetables. The same quantity of rice that we had taken was 1.5 cup. The same 1.5 cup of vegetables we will now add. So we will mix the vegetables. So I am adding a bit of carrots, some potatoes, other vegetables. So we added the vegetables. We will sort them well. Okay, so now all the vegetables are getting cooked. We will saute them well. If you really want to cook this a little faster, you can close the lid, but keep opening it and stirring it so that they don't catch at the bottom. At this stage, you can add a little bit more of salt. Okay, so now what we will do is, we will close the lid so that it can cook faster. You will have to keep opening the lid and stirring it so that it doesn't get burnt. Okay, so now our vegetables are half cooked. It's just the right way for making the pulao. So now I'm going to do is, I'm going to add the rice. I've taken 1.5 cup, rinsed them, and I'm going to add the rice to it. We had 1.5 cup of rice, so we need to double the quantity for water. So we will add about 3 cups. I'm going to add 2 cups of water first. I'll tell you why I'm adding just 2 cups. 1, 2. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take a little bit of yogurt and I'm going to mix the yogurt well. And I'm going to put about 1 tablespoon of yogurt, 4 teaspoons of milk powder. Now I would like to reiterate here, coconut milk is totally optional. So I've completely dissolved both of them. They made 1 cup exactly. Now I've added 2 cups of water, and I'm going to add 1 cup of this mix of yogurt and coconut milk. I'm going to give a nice stir. Can see how it looks. It looks really colorful. Now what we will do is, we will close the lid of the cooker and we will keep the flame on high and we will wait for the steam to come. And now the steam has come, we will put the weight and we will reduce the flame between 1 and 2. So it should not be very high, it should not be very low, it should be just medium. And the time after this should be exactly 8 minutes. If you leave it for more than 8 minutes, the rice will turn mushy and it will not be looking like a pulao. Okay, so now it's 8 minutes are over. We'll switch off the flame and we will wait for the steam to come down. It takes about 8 to 10 minutes for the steam to come down. While that's happening, let me explain how World Vision India tackles or addresses malnutrition. We work along with the government health center, the Anganwadis, the frontline workers, and ensure that our communities have access to health facilities. We also build awareness within the community, especially focusing on lactating mothers, pregnant mothers, mothers with five-year-old children and adolescent girls, and tell them about how nutrition is a key to building a very healthy life. We tell them how they can use the things that are growing around them in their own garden or at places nearby, which they can add into their food. So these are the different ways and different programs and interventions we have, wherein we help, we try to see and build awareness not just on overcoming malnutrition but also in addressing them. While the steam is coming down, we will prepare the yogurt salad with onions. I've taken one onion, sliced them finely. I've taken some curd. I'm going to add this onion slices and give them a nice mix. Just before going to serve, you can add a bit of salt, because if you add salt quite early, it will start leaving water. So I've just added, just because we're going to serve in the next 5 minutes. So I've added the salt, and there are salad is ready. Now the steam has come down, we'll take out the weight and we will open the lid and see how the pulao has turned out. Wow, that's like, you can see how the pulao has cooked right. What I'm going to do is now mix the pulao and then plate it out. So now we've put the pulao for serving it to Kevin, and this is mango pickle. This is usually every household in India will have this pickle or any other pickle. I'm adding one piece of mango pickle. Thank you all the World Vision supporters. As of now, good night and thank you.